14 confirmed cases of coronavirus in Cameroon. The Ministry of Public Health has announced that 14 confirmed cases of the coronavirus throughout the National Territory. Another Cameroonian was tested positive for the virus after a press conference Wednesday, during which Paul Malachi Mamadou mentioned three new cases, with two recorded in Bafoussam Basoujon after coming in contact with the first infected person, raising the number from 10 to 13. 3 years after the announcement, more one case, amounting to 14 cases in Cameroon. Cameroon Public Health Minister Dr. Mamadou sends an alert calling on all passengers of Air France 900 that landed at the Yaoundé airport on March 17 to go into quarantine themselves after three coronavirus cases were recorded. The administrative court has ordered municipal reruns of elections in some part of the northwest regions. The municipal council's concern at the Bafoud in the Mezam division and the Benakuma in the Montrem division. Decision come less than 24 hours after a same petition affected two councils in the far north, notably Marouane and Bouna Council. Bamenda-based journalist Larry Inchena narrates other ordeal after 2 days in Amba captivity, released on Wednesday, March 18. Larry recounts ugly experience he went through while in the hands of police fighting for the restoration. I speak to you right now, I cannot walk. My legs have swollen following 2 days beaten by Amazon bots, Larry Inchena tells. I was treated as a common criminal throughout my stay there. I was locked up in what they call a cell. The first day they bought rice for me to eat and I refused this and mysterious beating. Then the second day I had to eat to avoid another thrashing, Larry added. The journalist says separatist fighters kidnapped him just outside his gate and detained him for 2 days under horrible conditions, an accusation that he was been working with the military against the struggle for the restoration of Amazonian statehood, accusation hitting us. I'm a journalist and I report what happens on both sides of the war. If we were working for the military, I could not have risked my life living in Bamenda, otherwise called Ground Zero, where there are many fighters. On how he secured his release, the family of the journalist revealed he paid 100,000 francs as ransom. Barry Onuachu was kidnapped outside his gate on Tuesday, March 17, outside his gate in Bamenda by three boys on a board motorcycle. He declared the fact that journalists are roughly handed by both fighters and military in the course of the exercise of their duties. The appealing hearing of Sisiko Yoktabe and Co. will begin in the moments ahead today. Among those also hearing to court, we have learned that Mancho BBC and Co. were saying concerning prison protests months back and appeal on the case in connection with the Amazon crisis. MRC Vice President Mamadou Mouta appealing hearing is expected to come up on Monday. We have learned. And we call for the immediate release without preconditions. Thank you. Cameroon has suspended media coverage of National Assembly activities. This is according to a message from Chief of Communication and the Lower House of Parliament, who have ever failed to align reasons for their decisions. Cameroon, renowned hip-hop star, has stand in a certain words of comfort to fans and Cameroonians as a whole, as the country battles to stop the further spread of the coronavirus pandemic. So far, 13 cases have been confirmed in Cameroon, according to health authorities. Be safe, life is precious, and your safety matters most. Let's fight this together, the much award-winning singer said in his recent video. Lawyers of the Ambassadorian separatist leaders, Sisiko Yoktabe, are still uncertain regarding the client's case. The case, like others, was set to be postponed for 30 days. Prime Minister Diongute stated that the construction group was given that less than 50% in attendance. This comes as part of the measures to combat the coronavirus pandemic, which has plagued the country, the world, as a whole. Judges now will suspend cultural events amid coronavirus outbreak. His Majesty Tukuna Chen Raymond, Parliament ruler of Bemaka in the Upper Palo Division of the Western of Cameroon, has suspended all traditional marriages, funeral manifestations, displays, hunting, and practices. Could be more than 50 people across the Bemaka until further notice. Chairman for Bemaka, as is traditionally referred to, says this measure has frozen now the national effort to fight the spread of the coronavirus. And I will cover UKGBT Vice Prime Minister Diongute's order COVID parliamentary meeting sessions. Beyond Northwest itself, Northwest regions deserve better. The Legendary Cameroonian musician Emmanuel Dibango shocked his fans across the world and in Cameroon Pascal after announced Wednesday that he was tested positive for coronavirus pandemic. Emmanuel Dibango is taking some rest and recovering. Seniority wants you to respect his privacy and look forward to meeting soon. A Facebook which triggered several reactions. Several sources close to the saxophone confirmed that he was admitted to a French hospital for a disease when he got infected. As day one of the 13 measures to limit the coronavirus in Cameroon comes to an end, residents of Douala says force of law and order visited popular bars forcing them to go home. We depend on our generators for those bars to charge our phone, but now we are going home before they come down here and meet us. One resident says security forces, the local ads have promised to deal with anyone caught disregarding the Prime Minister's measure. Among other things, Prime Minister had instructed that bars should close by 6 p.m. The full bureau of Cameroon Lower House of Parliament is composed of Kaveri Kechebe, Vice Speaker. The Governor of Littoral Regions of Cameroon, Samuel Tiodune Evan Duba, has dismissed rumors that 400 coronavirus cases have been confirmed in Douala. In a press conference in Douala yesterday, the governor said less than 200 passengers arrived Douala Tuesday, March 17, have not been tested positive yet. He went further to say passengers have been quarantined in some hotels in the country. Despite government orders to shut down schools as part of measures to limit the spread of the coronavirus, some schools yesterday Wednesday, March 18, voluntary decision in where pupils and students could be seen heading to class yesterday morning. This is the same with some higher institutional learning in towns that have not halted their ongoing examinations. Schools in Cameroon have been shut down indefinitely as preventive measures against the coronavirus. Some few students and people that are at school in Douala yesterday were told to go home and wait when the government will announce school resumptions. Students in examination classes have been advised to continue studies at home while waiting for to end the corona epidemic virus. Prominent Kenyan doctors waiting for results after developing coronavirus symptoms. Ahmed Kalibe, the co-founder and chief executive of Lancet Laboratory, tweeted that he has self-isolated after developing fever and cough. Meantime, a man suspected of having coronavirus in southeast Kenya was beaten up by a group of youth and later died in the hospital. Kenyan Health Ministry has so far confirmed 7 cases of the virus. Mauritius, a popular choice, has imposed 2 weeks travel ban on citizens of the European Union, UK and Switzerland starting midnight. Local, the measures were taken after a recommendation from the World Organization to curb the spread of the coronavirus, which has caused the COVID-19 disease, said the Prime Minister Pravin Chunke. Zambia has confirmed its first 2 cases of the coronavirus. The respiratory illness caused by coronavirus involving a couple who had traveled to France. They had gone to holiday for 10 days with their children and were told to self-isolate on their return home on Sunday. Burkina Faso has announced its first death from coronavirus, especially in its caused by coronavirus. It is first recorded death from the coronavirus in West Africa. Authorities say the patient was Rosemary, compared with the vice president of the National Assembly. She was a diabetic woman, aged 62. We can extend our condolences to the family. Nigeria has placed a travel ban on people coming from 13 countries was affected by the coronavirus outbreak as 5 new cases were recorded in the African most populous nation. That brings the country's total number of patients with COVID to 8. South African President Cyril Ramaphosa has met leaders of the country's main political parties and has appealed for solidarity in the fight against the coronavirus. At the news conference, opposition politicians confirmed that they were backing the government efforts. South Africa has seen another jump in the coronavirus case with 116 now confirmed as the country has introduced new measures to shut its border and schools across the country. The number is rising sharply from 1 case to 4 nights ago. Zambia's President Emmerson Mnangagwa has declared a national disaster over coronavirus case. Even as the country said to confirm any case, Mr. Mnangagwa has postponed Independence Day celebration scheduled for April 18 and banned all public gathering of more than 100 people. Humanitarian organizations are struggling to keep the peace with the increasing needs of civilians as conflict between the government and the poor independent scope escalating Cameroon and reform with just limited access to those children from their homes, low level of journal funding, and with 8 workers of discovered as government obstruction means majority of the 1.3 million people affected by the virus cannot be reached. Since November 2019, there have been a surge in violence in the north and south regions of collected by the poor independence fighters as the Southern Cameroon or Republic of Mbazonia. Nearly 900,000 people have been made homeless, in addition to 60,000 have fled into neighboring Nigeria. A four-year conflict triggered by perceived marginalization of the region from majority French-speaking, Cameroon has left 2,000 deaths in the Anglophone regions.